If you are a technology professional who has spent, let's say, a good few years in an IT company, and if you are looking at an MBA program, I am pretty sure a lot of you out there are thinking, how can I leverage my background in technology? In this video, I am going to be telling you a bunch of such programs that you should be having if you are looking at getting a tech MBA. So first, let's look at the pure tech MBA programs. These are offered by some of the top schools. So the first such program is the Stern Tech MBA. Now, this is really a one-year course, and the application process is very similar to what you have for the regular MBA course. The thing with NYU Stern is I really think the location that you're going to be in New York, right? So that gives you access to a lot of companies, and people think that not many technology companies are there on the East Coast, but most large companies will have an office in New York or in the periphery, right? So I think locationally also Stern has a good weight. The other thing is the Stern regular MBA program in many of these rankings appears routinely somewhere in the, you know, top 10, top 15. So that way you also have the pedigree of the MBA granting institution. The other cool thing about the Stern MBA program is that it also offers you a STEM MBA. STEM stands for Science, Technology, Engineering and Mathematics, which automatically gives you an opportunity to extend your visa by another 24 months. So in case you have heard of that, this MBA program actually gives you that runway or leeway. The second MBA program that you should be looking at is the Cornell Tech MBA program. This Tech MBA program is again a one-year MBA program. Starts off with an intense, 10-week program where they teach you the core business and leadership aspects that you need to know. And post that, you will move to their New York campus. In January, between those two semesters, you also have the opportunity to travel to Israel to network and present your business solution to local startups. Also, the other part is Cornell by itself is, you know, one of the Ivy League colleges, has good brand credentials, kind of, you know, placed in the East Coast, so also gives you access to large cities. So net, definitely a program that you must consider. The third program that I would like to talk about is the Tech MBA program offered by Foster School of Management, which is the University of Washington. Now, if you look at it, this Technology Management MBA is also a, you know, accelerated MBA program. It's an 18-month program. And what it really does is it kind of focuses on technology, right? So that's really going to be where you're going to be focusing on. And the thing that you need to understand about a program like this is that this program is in Seattle, right? Home to Microsoft, home to Amazon, right? So these are large tech players. And when you have two of the largest companies in the world in one geographic area, what you realize is that a lot of other things also start growing in that area. For example, there are a lot of small boutique tech consulting firms, right, in very specialized niches. So, you know, that's where the employment opportunities also open up. So I think locationally, this is a great school, has typically had a lot of people go into, you know, tech careers. So you also have a very strong alumni base. The fourth program that I would like to talk about is not really in the US. In fact, it's in Spain. It is the Tech MBA offered by the IE School of Business. This Tech MBA is one of the first such programs in the whole of Europe. And what it really promises is it promises to develop professionals who want to have a career in the technology sector, right? So it assumes that you already have a background in technology. Very clearly on the website, it's a one-year program, and it's written in bold. It says, this program focuses 100% on business for tech. So what these four programs really do is they give you a tailored MBA program meant for people who are very clear they are going to work in this sector. So if you have that level of clarity, if technology excites you and you think that you can contribute to a tech company, not just with your technology skills, but also with certain business skills, then these programs should be on your list. I'm going to add three more schools to this list, though they don't have explicit tech MBA. I think they are very, very strong when it comes to technology. The first such program would be the Tepper MBA at Carnegie Mellon University, CMU. This program essentially offers a technology strategy and product management MBA track. Earlier, it was called the technology leadership track. And what this track really does is it emphasizes on the management part of running a high-tech company, right? So that's really where it is. And it's very clear that it wants to prepare its students who aspire for senior positions, such as product managers or technology, consultants, or maybe even a VP of products or a CTO kind of role through this MBA program. One more school that I like, and it's not very pretentious, it says what it is the Georgia Tech Scheller MBA program. Right? So they very clearly say that we are a program where people who come in with the technology orientation will thrive. I know a lot of former students who have become technology consultants, people who have moved into product management. So that program also has a very strong focus on technology. In fact, they have an MBA core, which is the Information Technology Management core. It is in Atlanta, and Atlanta offers you that locational advantage, as I said, very crucial when it comes to something like tech. But I'm going to throw in a small bonus over here. I'm also going to be talking about a few more programs that you should be looking at. They don't offer a tech MBA, it's not like a specialization, but these are programs that are great for various other reasons. The first one in this list would be Stanford. Just the locational advantage it has of being in the Bay Area provides Stanford with, access to, great companies in technology, right? And many of the tech companies started off from Stanford. So you can imagine the number of product managers at Google who are going to be hired from Stanford. Then you have Haas, Berkeley, again in the Bay Area, right in Silicon Valley, which means you again have access to that set of companies, I would strongly recommend looking at that program also. Similarly, you could probably look at other programs. For example, I also know that the University of Texas at Austin, the McCombs MBA program, also has a sector on tech, which means that if you are very clear that you want a career in technology, that MBA program should also be on your list. Because it's in Austin, and if you see, a lot of companies are today in the US moving away from slightly expensive places like California and moving to places like Texas. So that also could work to your advantage. Apart from this, I would also encourage you to look at schools, especially UK, because now with the new visa rule where you have a 2-year window after you do your MBA from UK. How could this be complete without me mentioning about MIT? So MIT, obviously, even the regular MBA program known for its tech thing. You could also explore other programs. Like I said, both Stanford and MIT have this unique pedigree because of their tech schools, that they also offer programs for people who have been in IT for slightly longer. For example, the Stanford has the MSX program for people who have minimum 8 years experience. It's a 1-year accelerated fellowship. Similarly, at MIT, you have the SDM program. That is the System Design and Management program, which again is kind of catering to people with slightly more experience. So my suggestion would be to also look at these kind of programs if you have slightly more experience. I hope this gave you a good insight into the kind of programs that you should apply if you are looking at continuing in the technology industry. If you like this video, please go ahead and let us know by liking this video, sharing it with your friends. And if you have any queries about the whole MBA process, please go ahead, let us know in the comments below. We would love to help clarify that for you.